I think some of you know I was a former teacher. So I can't tell you how absolutely imperative that those children at a young age have nurturing. You could tell when those kids would walk into your classroom what kids were loved and nurtured and what kids weren't. That sounds a little crazy, but it's the truth. And if it wasn't for these kinds of programs, our children would be way behind. The other thing I want to share with you, because I'm probably the oldest person here. I think I'm the oldest person here. There was a time when families lived together. So we lived in a half a double block with my grandmother and grandfather, my mom and dad, and then I came along. So there was always a caretaker, whether it was my grandmother or grandfather, mom, dad went to work. Jaji, my grandfather, that's Polish, he went to work, and Bushi, grandma, and my mom were at home, cleaning, taking care of the kids, educating you, doing those things. As time went on, what happened? In order to improve your life, mom went to work, dad went to work, because life was starting to cost more. Now you're sending your kids to college, that costs X amount of dollars, you need an extra job in order to do that. Well, now, where do those children go? So the choice is mom stays home, make less money, slow down the process, slow down the opportunity, or mom works and dad works, and now those children have opportunities. But the cost of childcare today is around $12,000 a year. Sudi, I'm not sure exactly what you're charging here, but the bottom line is that's a lot of money. So for regular folks that are from this area, including myself that grew out of a miner's family, $12,000 was a huge amount of money. So the programs that the governor has sponsored and we've been able to pass, and the good management that the governor has provided, the first time in many years, governor, where we've actually had balances where we've had more dollars that we're able to help out. This, you heard from one of our moms. It would be impossible. So it is this combination of federal dollars, state dollars, the distribution of that to help the parents maintain the jobs. I just came from Allied Services. And I'm sure all of you that are in the news media have heard time and time again. What is one of the things that most businesses need? Employees. They don't have enough people working. A lot of people have retired. They have now moved on, and you don't have enough people coming up. Or, because of the way things have happened, and I want to mention this about this area, the average hourly rate was about $8.35. Then Chewy came in, the distribution centers. Rate went to $9.35. Pandemic came in, blew everything apart. Couldn't get workers. What happened? They're paying $15, $7. Who would have ever thought McDonald's would pay $15 an hour? $17, $18, $20 an hour. Sign-on bonuses. What is it telling you? People, employers are looking for people to work. The only way you're going to do that is they're going to have to increase the dollars. Well, then how do regular folks are able to do all that? So without some of these programs that the governor has sponsored, it wouldn't happen. And the demand still continues. But working together, working with the programs that have been brought out, now we can begin to get our way out of this pandemic and develop a future for everybody. Our children are the most important things. They are the future. There's no doubt it's a challenge. We're going to continue to work together and try to subsidize the best that we can.